गेट रेडी फॉर द डिक्टेशन. डिक्टेशन विल स्टार्ट इन 5 सेकेंड्स. स्टार्ट. By 42%, we do not exactly know how it has been distributed. It is not enough to say that the per capita income has increased. The right question that has to be answered by us is whether it has increased in terms of real income. For that, we have to see whether the price level has kept pace with the wage level. It is no satisfaction to a man that his nominal income has gone up, though at the same time the price level has reduced his purchasing power, not only for luxury articles but for articles of common consumption. Concessions have been made to industrialists. Perhaps it was inevitable that they should be made. We had to provide incentives for capital formation, but the budget, even after the reliefs given, which I gratefully acknowledge, will, I apprehend, price increase the burden of the common man. The middle classes are the backbone of any community. There is dissatisfaction amongst them because of the rising prices. It is essential that in a mixed economy such as ours, the state should evolve a machinery of adequate price control. Prices should not be allowed to go beyond a certain level, and there must be a ceaseless war against holders and profiteers. They are pests of society and should be looked upon as such. Equality of sacrifice demands that those who have more should be made to pay more than those who have less. The marginal utility of money is greater with pupil of less money than with big monies. The third point that I would like to point out is that concentration of economic power should be discouraged. One of our articles provides that the ownership and marginal material resources of the country should be so distributed as to serve the common good. Another article provides that there should be suitable legislation for a living wage, fair conditions of work, decent standard of life, social and cultural activities, and full enjoyment and leisure, as also for the promotion of cottage industries on an individual and corporative basis in rural areas. The progress of the plan has to be tested in the light of these objectives. Small and medium-sized concerns should be encouraged so that concentration of wealth may break up. We would like to have the results of the inquiry as to how the national dividend has been distributed early. We should know how are the classes who have benefited most by our plans. Are they the pupil with weak capital? The spirit of the constitution is against the concentration of wealth in single hands, and this should be borne in mind by us, full stop.